If you can find this pattern, and it's from this ideology, it must be valid. I'm speaking of how the fake grievance studies papers got peer-reviewed. If it appears as if you're coming from a particular ideology, and you can cite enough sources, you can get published in peer-reviewed journals. That's scary as far as I'm concerned. And yes, this is somewhat old news, but I never chimed in on it until now. People can find misogyny in just about anything. Some people find it misogynistic to portray women as shorter than men. People get outraged at emojis. It's actually said that any character in any cartoon that is dark in color, regardless of what kind of animal or alien it's supposed to be representing, if it's a bad guy and it's dark in color, it's racist against black people. I've seen people say that the White House is a symbol of racism because of its name and color alone, never mind other things about it. So it wouldn't surprise me if people started declaring that any glorification of anything that happens to be white in color is a symbol of white supremacy and is leftovers of the outdated idea that white is superior. White paper is promoting white supremacy. Toilet paper is the ultimate symbol of white supremacy because you use it to wipe off brown stuff and flush it down the toilet. I mean, seriously, when people say that Miss Pac-Man is sexist because it supposedly reduces women to superficial things, like a bow in someone's hair, and a bunch of sheep nod in agreement and declare that you're misogynistic if you disagree with them, you know there's something going wrong in terms of the way we're formally studying things nowadays. Especially since the latter part of 2013. Just because you can see a pattern doesn't mean it has any importance or significance. It doesn't give the pattern any significant weight. It doesn't mean the pattern is intentional, nor does it mean the pattern is actually harmful. Sure, in some instances, a number of patterns are harmful, but this would include patterns that, for the most part, do positive things. Clean water is deadly if you drink enough of it. When we stop looking for the positive things in our patterns, we're on a trajectory of destruction. This goes for one's personal life as well. You have to look at your positive patterns or you'll start thinking about permanent solutions to temporary problems. We've reached a point in our society where many of these studies seem to only be good for destroying the progress we've made, whether that's intentional or unintentional. It's a pattern that I doubt the sociology fundamentalists have the ability to self-reflect over. This really is like watching religious fundamentalists in the 1980s all over again. Only this time it's coming from what's supposed to be higher education. What do we have to counter it? Unfortunately, traditional beliefs are what's countering it. It's why there's such a rise of the right, particularly online. If we wouldn't have let it get to this point, traditionalism wouldn't be on the rise. But you know, if you say anything negative about it, you'll be labeled as a sexist, misogynistic, racist, white supremacist. Just like people used to be labeled heathens, sinners, that were going to burn in hell for eternity for not agreeing that Jesus is the way and you should repent.